Standard 6, Subject English, Unit 1.3, Autobiography of the Great Indian Bustard, Dr. Pramod Patil. A little information about our author, Dr. Pramod Patil. Dr. Pramod Patil, a medical doctor by education, but a passionate wildlife conservationist by career. His empathy for grasslands and all the forgotten large and small species that depend on them has carried him far from the sterile confines of city hospitals. A full-time conservationist now, Dr. Patil has been appointed an advocacy officer with the Bombay Natural History Society, BNHS, and works holistically on all issues related to the protection of the great Indian bustard. Recently, he won the Whitley Award at the Royal Geographical Society, London, in honor of his work to protect the iconic great Indian bustard. Let's understand the explanation of the lesson, An Autobiography of a Great Indian Bustard. What is an autobiography? An autobiography is a self-written account of the life of oneself. So here, this is an autobiography of a great Indian bustard. We shall first read the lesson. Which is the heaviest flying bird in India? Well, friends, it's me, the great Indian bustard. I feel proud to be known as the great Indian bustard. I have more than 30 different names in various Indian languages. In Marathi, I am known as Maldhok or Hoom. I can weigh up to 18 kilos and can stand up to 4 feet in height, reaching up to your shoulders or even higher. I have got a long white neck, brown wings, tall yellow legs, and a black cap on my head. My wife, Mrs. Bustard, is smaller and slimmer than I am, and her neck is not white. But I have heard humans say that we both look impressive. In this paragraph, the bustard is giving an account of its self. It begins by saying that it is the heaviest flying bird in India, and it has more than 30 different names in various Indian languages. In Marathi, the great Indian bustard is known as Maldhok or Hoom, and it weighs up to 18 kilos and can stand up to 4 feet in height, reaching up to one's shoulders, the shoulders of a person. A description of the male Indian bustard. Look at this picture. It has a long white neck, brown wings. The legs are yellow, tall yellow legs, and it has a black cap on its head. This is the female bustard. Here it is mentioned Mrs. Bustard. She is smaller and slimmer than the male great Indian bustard, and her neck is not white. She is smaller and slimmer than the male Indian bustard, and humans say that both the male great Indian bustard and the female great Indian bustard look very impressive. I live on grasslands and deserts along with my other friends, including chinkara, black buck, and larks. I eat everything, including snakes, lizards, small fruits, and berries, and all sorts of insects. That's a very healthy habit. But grasshoppers and beetles are my favorite food items. In this paragraph, the great Indian bustard gives an account of where it lives. It lives on the grasslands and deserts. Here, this is the picture of a grassland and this is a desert. And the great Indian bustard lives along with other friends, including the chinkara and black buck and the lark. Lark is a bird. The things that the great Indian bustard eats. It eats snakes, lizards, and small fruits and berries. You can look at this picture here. It eats snakes, lizards, and small fruits and berries. But the favorite food item of the great Indian bustard is the beetle and the grasshoppers. When it starts raining, we all gather at our favorite grasslands where there are no people to disturb us. I perform a wonderful dance by gulping air in the special feathery pouch attached below my neck. This pouch helps me to produce a resonating sound similar to the one produced by the cow. I dance in joy with puffed out feathers and cocked up tail and dropped down wings. It helps me to impress my soulmate. Here in this paragraph, the great Indian bustard talks about the mating season. When it starts raining, all the male great Indian bustard, they gather at their favorite grassland where there are no people to disturb them. And the male Indian bustard performs a wonderful dance by gulping air in a special feathery pouch that is attached below its neck. This pouch helps the bird to produce a resonating sound. The meaning of resonating is a deep sound, a deep reverberating sound, similar to the one that is produced by the cow. And the sound is hoom. The great Indian bustard, in order to impress the female great Indian bustard, it dances in joy with puffed out feathers, cocked up tail, and dropped down wings. This helps the male bustard to impress the female bustard. You know that we birds lay eggs and our young ones hatch out of eggs. Mother Great Indian Bustard lays just one egg directly on the ground. We don't believe in building nests, but we have a special trick to protect our eggs from predators. The eggs look like a stone. Monitor lizards, foxes, dogs, pigs, snakes, and eagles are enemies of my egg and chick. But my wife protects the egg from all of them. By the time our young one hatches out of the egg, rains arrive. There's plenty of grass swarming with insects, fresh food for my family. Young ones of other birds soon fly away from the nest. But a great Indian bustard mother and chick stay together for nearly 1 year. The chick learns many good habits from the mother. Here in this paragraph, the great Indian bustard talks about the eggs that the mother bird lays. The mother great Indian bustard lays just one egg directly on the ground, and they do not believe in building nests, but they have a special trick or a way to protect the eggs from predators. Predators are the enemies. Who are the predators? The monitor lizard, the eagle, the fox, the dog, the pigs, the snakes. They are all enemies of the egg and the chick. The mother great Indian bustard protects the egg from all these predators. By the time the young ones hatch out of the egg, rains arrive and there is plenty of grass, insects, and fresh food for the entire family, for the family of the great Indian bustard. The young ones of other birds, they fly away from their nest as soon as they're ready to fly. But a great Indian bustard mother and chick stay together for nearly 1 year. Look at the picture over here of the mother great Indian bustard and the chick. So they stay together for nearly a year. And the chick learns many good habits from the mother bird. You may have heard about a great human friend of ours, Dr. Salim Ali. He had even suggested that we should be given the status of the national bird of our country. But the honor went to our beautiful relative, the peacock. I am happy to tell you that I am the state bird of Rajasthan. We have got 10 sanctuaries for our protection, but sadly, our number is still going down. We used to live in all parts of India, but slowly the growing population of man pushed us away from more than 90% of our home regions. We are afraid of hunters that kill us for fun. We also die due to electric power lines that we can't see while flying. We are losing our homes. Today, only the last 200 of us are left in the world. We need your support and love in order to survive. Can you help us? Here in this paragraph, the great Indian bustard tells us that a great human friend of theirs, Dr. Salim Ali. Look at the picture of Dr. Salim Ali. A little information about Dr. Salim Ali, an Indian ornithologist and naturalist, sometimes referred to as the Birdman of India. Dr. Salim Ali was the first Indian to conduct systematic bird surveys across India and wrote several bird books that popularized ornithology in India. He was also the key figure behind the Bombay Natural History Society. Dr. Salim Ali was awarded the Padma Bhushan in 1958 and the Padma Vibhushan in 1976. They are India's third and second highest civilian honors. Several species of birds, a couple of bird sanctuaries and institutions also are named after Dr. Salim Ali. He's the Birdman of India. So he had suggested that the status of the national bird of our country be given to the great Indian bustard. But the honor went to the peacock. As we know, the peacock is the national bird of our country. But the great Indian bustard says that it has the honor of being the state bird of Rajasthan. Now, there are 10 sanctuaries for the protection. Yeah, this is the picture of a sanctuary for the protection of these birds, but still their number is going down. Their number is declining because of the population. Man has encroached certain areas, so that is why it has pushed away the great Indian bustard from 90% of their home regions. The great Indian bustard is also afraid of hunters who kill them for fun. Number of the great Indian bustard also lose their life due to electrocution. They get electrocuted due to the electric power lines. You see the picture over here of a dead great Indian bustard who died due to electrocution because they cannot see. You can see the picture of these electric power lines. They cannot see those power lines when they are flying. So number of them die because of electric power lines. They get electrocuted. Because of man's encroachment, they are also losing their habitat or their home. And there are only 200 left in the world. So the great Indian bustard is asking for our help and our support. So children, can we help the great Indian bustard? You can write letters to your leaders and make an appeal to help us. You can make my drawings and submit it to your teacher. You can discuss this with your parents. Come to see us at a sanctuary, because now you will not see us in other places. And who knows, if humans don't help us, none of us will be left on the earth. You will only see us in pictures. We know that the great Indian bustard, they're losing their homes. Some of them are even dying because of electrocution. Hunters also kill them. So the great Indian bustard is asking us for our support and our love. It's making an appeal for help. How can we help the great Indian bustard from getting extinct or declining? What can we do? Here are a few suggestions. What could we do? We could write letters to our leaders, make an appeal in order to save the great Indian bustard, just as our author Dr. Pramod Patil, who is a conservationist, has done a lot of work in order to save the great Indian bustard. We could also make drawings of the bird and submit it to our teachers. We could discuss with our parents. We could also go to certain sanctuaries, bird sanctuaries, and see the great Indian bustard over there, because we will not be able to see them in other places. And if we humans do not help in protecting and conserving nature and or protecting the great Indian bustard, none of these birds will be left on earth, and finally they will be extinct. It will be a very sad story. We will only get to see these birds in pictures. So it is an appeal that we need to protect and conserve the nature. We have to conserve environment. We have to protect certain species of animals and birds. Protect the species of the great Indian bustard. Homework to be done: write a short autobiography of any bird or animal of your choice. Write a letter to your friend about the great Indian bustard. You may use the following points. Why do we need to protect the bird? What do you plan to do to help the bird? Complete exercise 5 and 12 given at the end of the lesson.